There's a pattern of Israel bombing and killing people in Gaza, then claiming it made a mistake.
This tragic mistake.
And this mistake in war, a mistake was made.
This is a grave mistake.
Only after there's public outcry. On the 26th of May, Israeli airstrikes killed over 40 Palestinians in their displaced tents in Rafah, an area designated by Israel as a safe zone. What was Israel's response after the global outcry to the massacre and graphic scenes? Netanyahu said it was a tragic mishap or mistake. Israel initially claimed it was targeting two Hamas officials but produced no evidence to back up these claims. 2 days later, Israel targeted a nearby area in Rafah again and killed over 22 Palestinians in their tents. In April, Israel killed 7 foreign aid workers in Gaza with 3 consecutive airstrikes on clearly marked vehicles for the World Central Kitchen. Then Israel said it was a serious mistake only after there was global outrage and condemnation of the brutal killings of foreign aid workers, despite the aid group coordinating their movements with the Israeli army. Israel said those who approved the strikes were convinced that they were targeting armed Hamas operatives and not World Central Kitchen employees. Back in March, Israel targeted and killed 2 Palestinians on their bikes and then claimed it had mistaken the bikes for RPG rocket launchers. Are you seeing a pattern? In February, Israeli forces fired indiscriminately at hundreds of Palestinians seeking aid in northern Gaza. Israeli forces killed at least 100 Palestinians that day, and this became known as the Flower Massacre. According to Al Jazeera's reporter who was at the scene, after opening fire, Israeli tanks advanced and ran over many of the dead and injured bodies. Israel's official statements then said Palestinians died after being trampled in a stampede, and that its forces fired at a number of suspects who moved towards their soldiers. United Nations staff who visited those being treated in the Al-Shifa hospital at the time said the injured were being treated for bullet wounds. In December, an Israeli airstrike killed at least 86 people in the Maghazi refugee camp in central Gaza. Then the Israeli spokesperson at the time called it a regrettable mistake and claimed it was down to the use of incorrect munitions. Also in December, Israel killed 3 of its own hostages during armed clashes with Hamas fighters. Then, an IDF spokesperson said the 3 were mistakenly identified as a threat. The hostages were reportedly waving white flags. The late Dr. Rifat Al-Arir, a poet and professor of literature from Gaza who was killed by an Israeli airstrike on his home in December, said in a lecture back in 2021,
like if Israel bombs some area here or there, you just ask the question, okay, there must be something that made Israel bomb this particular area or this particular house. But most often, Israel will come out and like, oops, we made a mistake. Oops, we killed these 50 people by mistake. We didn't mean to kill these. We didn't know that Israel that knows everything with the technology and everything here.
Now, when we look back at the killing of 6-year-old Hind Rajab at the end of January this year, Israel's response claimed that its forces were not present near the vehicle or within the firing range. A Washington Post investigation later found that Israeli armed vehicles were present in the area that afternoon. Also, the gunfire audible as Hind and her cousin Leanne begged for help and the extensive damage caused to the ambulance were consistent with Israeli weapons. All the way back in October, following a suspected Israeli strike on the Al Ahli hospital in northern Gaza, Israel blamed it on misfired Palestinian rockets, a claim they didn't back up with conclusive evidence and one that Palestinian groups vehemently denied. Following an investigation, Forensic Architecture said while what happened at Al Ahli remains inconclusive, the Israeli military launched an aggressive disinformation campaign. When Al Jazeera reporter Shireen Abu Akleh was deliberately killed by an Israeli sniper in Jenin in 2022, Israel initially tried to deflect the blame on Palestinian fighters in the area. Investigations later confirmed that it was indeed an Israeli sniper that deliberately targeted and killed Shireen Abu Akleh. In May this year, after Israel admitted killing 5 of its own young soldiers by mistake, Israel's military leaders apologized for both incidents and promised to sharpen their rules of engagement. Israel repeatedly claims it does not target civilians and boasts being one of the most technologically advanced military powers in the world. Yet, in the last 200 days, Israel has dropped over 75,000 tons of explosives on Gaza and killed over 36,000 people, the majority of whom are women and children. Many people have not only questioned the Israeli military's competence and rules of engagement, but they're also questioning Israel's intent in its war on Gaza. Israel is now facing genocide charges as its accusers say that its intention to harm and kill civilians in Gaza is deliberate.